That night, I left my father's house forever. I took the first right and the second left, and this time I went as far as California. Peggy and I visited him once or twice. Then he came to California to visit us and had a fever and swollen ankles. And we put him in the hospital. He never left. The reason at which he could accept for not leaving, the swollen ankles. But the real reason, the arteries were hardening. And he gradually, over several years, slipped into a complete speechless senility with all his life centered in his burning eyes. When I would visit him, we would sit and look at each other. His eyes would mist over, and his nostrils would pinch with emotion. I never knew what that emotion was. Anger, or love, or regret. One day, sitting in his wheelchair, staring without comprehension at television, he died. Alone, without even an orange in his hand. Death ends a life, but it does not end the relationship. What struggles on in the survivor's mind towards some resolution which it never finds. Alice said, "I would not accept the sadness of this world. What did it matter if I never loved him or if he never loved me?" Perhaps she's right. But still, when I hear the word, Father,